Hello friends, welcome to Dream Weaver Crocheting with Love. This is the part 2 tutorial of our baby frock for a 0 to 3 month old baby. In our part 1, we had worked this yoke. In case you haven't gone through the tutorial, I shall give the link of the same below for your reference. Now in this tutorial, we'll be working with the skirt part of the frock. For that, I'll be joining this multicolor yarn. Chain 1 and into the same stitch I'll be working a V stitch. 1 double crochet followed by 2 chains and 1 double crochet all into the same space. Now skip the next stitch and work 1 fan stitch, that is 2 double crochet followed by 1 chain and 2 more double crochet all into the same stitch. Again skip the next stitch and work 1 V stitch into the next. So the sequence is very simple. You need to work 1 V stitch, skip the next stitch and work a fan. Again skip the next stitch and work a V stitch. So you will just continue like this till you reach the end of the row. So here I have come to the end of the first row of our skirt part, where I had worked a V stitch and a fan stitch alternately and skipping one stitch between them. So at the end of the row I have a fan stitch, since the first stitch was a V stitch, so at the end we have a fan stitch. Now in order to end this row, we will work a slip stitch. So this finishes the row 1. Now slip stitch into the chain 2 space of the V stitch. Now again this is a row of V stitches and fan stitches, but they will be worked in a slight different manner. Now into the chain 2 space of each of the V stitches we will be working a fan stitch, and into the chain 1 space of each of the fan stitches we will be working a V stitch. So since the first stitch is a V stitch, so into the chain 2 space of the V stitch we will be working a fan stitch. So we need to make 2 double crochet followed by 1 chain and 2 more double crochets all into the same space. So here we have done the first fan stitch. Now moving to the chain 1 space of a fan stitch of a previous row, we will be working a V stitch, that is 1 double crochet, 2 chains and 1 double crochet. Again moving to the V stitch, work a fan stitch. So this is the sequence for this row. So in order to make the pattern more clearer, you have to work both V stitch as well as fan stitch alternately. But see to that you swap the pattern as compared to the previous row. By that I mean on top of a V stitch of the previous row you will be working a fan stitch, and on top of the fan stitch of the previous row you will be working a V stitch. So just continue working like this till the end of the row. So here I have done the second row of our skirt part with this multicolored yarn and cut the yarn. From here on, this is basically a repeat sequence of the two rows, that is the row 1 and row 2, which will be repeated again and again for the desired length of our skirt. Now I'll be joining the main color. Into the chain 1 space of our fan stitch. So in order to work the row 3, which is the repeat sequence of row 1, chain 1 and work a V stitch, that is double crochet followed by 2 chains and double crochet into the same space. Again moving to the chain 2 space of the V stitch, I'll be working a fan stitch, that is 2 double crochet 1 chain and 2 double crochet. Now for the next 3 rows I'll be using this main color. After that I'll change color back to the multicolored yarn. So that all depends upon your own choice. You can make as many rows as you want with one color and then change colors. Now I'll be working exactly 17 rows from here on. 2 rows are already done, so I'll be working 15 more rows. Changing colors in this sequence, that is 2 rows I'll do with multicolored yarn followed by 3 rows with the main color. So just continue working like this for total of 17 rows. So as I mentioned before, I have done 17 rows of the skirt part. Now in order to make the final row, which is of shell stitches, we'll be joining the main colored yarn on the back part of the skirt. We need to join the yarn in the chain 2 space off of the V stitch. Chain 1 and work 5 triple crochets for making the shell. So here I have done the shell using 5 triple crochets. Now again work 1 chain and into the chain 2 space of the fan stitch work 1 single crochet. Again chain 1 and into the chain 2 space of the V stitch work a shell of 5 triple crochets. So you will be repeating this till the end of the row, that is working a shell of 5 triple crochets followed by 1 chain and 1 single crochet into the chain 1 space of the fan stitch, again 1 chain and a shell stitch of 5 triple crochets into the chain 2 space of the V stitch. So just continue working like this till you reach the end. So here I have done with the 18th row of shell stitches, and after doing the last shell stitch I have a slip stitch on top of the first triple crochet work. Now the next task would be to work with the sleeves where we'll be making the ruffles. Now as you can see, I've already done one sleeve with ruffles. Now I shall teach you how to make the ruffles on the other side. For this we'll be using the multicolored yarn. So we need to join our yarn into the corner stitch from where we had joined the sleeves. So just insert your hook into the corner stitch. And work 1 chain. Now moving into the next double crochet, you'll be working 2 double crochet into the first stitch. So you have done the 2 double crochets. Now moving to the next stitch, I'll be working 3 double crochet. Now again into the next stitch I'll be working 2 double crochet. So this is the sequence, that is working 2 double crochet into the first stitch followed by 3 double crochets into the next. So when you work double crochet in increases in this way, the ruffles will be getting formed. So just continue working like this till you reach the last double crochet of the sleeve. So here after working with the ruffles on the sleeve part, I have come to the end by working 2 double crochets on top of the last double crochet of the sleeve. In order to complete this, we will be working a slip stitch into the chain 1 space of the corner. So just go into it and work a slip stitch and cut the yarn. So here we have done with the ruffles of the sleeve. Now in the similar way, you will be working the other sleeve too, which I have already done. Now next step would be to make a flower and sew it in the center part of our yoke and sew buttons on the back part. Here I have already done with this flower. The tutorial for this flower is there in our channel. I shall give the link of the same above for your reference, so that you can just go through it and get to know how this flower is worked out. Now we'll be sewing the buttons on the back part of our baby dress. So here I have sewed one of the buttons. Now we'll be working with the next button. While sewing the buttons, you should see to that you align the buttons accordingly to the buttonhole that you have created on the other side. So the buttonhole comes along the first row of the yoke. So I need to stitch the button on this side on the first row. So after sewing about 5 to 6 times, you have to just go on the back part and tie tight knots. And cut the thread. So this is how your frock looks on the back part. And this is how it will look on the front part after sewing the flower on the center portion of the yoke. Now as I mentioned, while making the yoke, you can customize the yoke as per your size requirement, and then you can make the frock referring to the size chart that I had mentioned in the part 1 of this tutorial. We had seen in the size chart, the height of the frock for a 0 to 3 month old baby should be around 12.75 inches. So this perfectly matches with that. And depending upon the age for whom you are making this frock, you can work those many number of rows for the skirt, and see to that the height of the frock is as per the measurement mentioned in the size chart. So that's all for today's tutorial. I hope you really found it very interesting as well as useful too. If you have any queries, please let me know through comments. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.